a senior person, of course, in our acting director for social welfare, Laji Sam Sani Amma. Okay, welcome for the program, sir.
Thank you.
Just as a backboard talk, and of course, we know not only backboard talk, but things are very difficult now for the country. You understand, of course, and your department, your area where you cover, the Lord is your strength all the time as they go. You understand, because there will not be small area to fit cater for people. You understand? So we'll go start with how you will fit it, I mean, how so far. What would be your assessment of taking care of, apart from the disabled people? We'll look the disabled people, their own, a special one. But we'll look at the issue of those normal people with the street, first of all, most are from that area. How far are they go? Because the work will not be small work.
Honestly, you're absolutely right. It's not a small work. It's not easy. Mm. Especially to people that their mindset have been psychologically affected in a negative way. First and foremost, I would like to appreciate the Federal Capital Territory Administration. By the grace of the Almighty, President Muhammadu Buhari had done a very good, favor to FCT, Federal Capital Territory, by appointing leaders with passion, leaders with integrity, leaders that have concern with human and humanity, leaders who's humane. Muhammad Musa Bello, Honorable Minister, and the Minister of State, Dr. Ramatu Tijana Aliu, and the meticulous guardian, I can call him a guardian, the Permanent Secretary, Olusha Adi Adeshola. These people are wonderful in supporting all our programs. Sometimes they even direct us on if we tend to, in the process of articulating our services, where they notice something, they'll call you director and sit you down and make you to understand the importance of certain things that you are even omitting in the process of discharging our duty. Well, the people we are talking about are persons with that stand on the street to mitigate their body, especially. Some of them claimed that they are from indigent family, whereby they cannot even afford to pay for exam like NACO, NAFTEP, because most of them you discover that they are dropouts. Some from JSS, some before they complete their secondary school, they drop out because they were not able to, according to what they said. This is just a claim. So we have gone so far. Presently, we have about three different programs we are running for them. Our first target was, we targeted, because it's just like the take-off, a pilot scheme, a kind of scholarship for educational empowerment. We targeted 500, these are our young ladies residing in the Federal Capital Territory, for them to be able to achieve the target of having NACO Martin Waik certificate, which will enable them to either proceed or use it for any other business. This is according to one of the 13 mandates of President Muhammad Buhari that he assigned to the Federal Capital Territory to achieve basic education.
Why other states not fit assess this kind of thing? Why you think say now only FCT we can't get this kind of privilege when happen to? Or you think say get the other states of the country?
Well, you know, Federal Capital Territory Administration is limited to Federal Capital Territory only.
Okay.
You know, states, they have their own priority. Okay. It's so that you see,
they have their own
governors, they have their own programs, and the way they, approach it is quite different from our own.
Okay.
So I mentioned three programs within these services for our young sisters and daughters out there in order to stop standing by the street. Jabi Primary School is where we organized tutorial to prepare them to write NECU and NAFTEP. And at the same time, we have the support of some universities that we partner with for IGMB program with a waiver of tuition fee, admission fee, tutorial and whatever, only limited to internal and external examination charges, which is not more than 60,000. And the course, you know, IGMB is 9-month course, after which you sat for your exam. If you qualified, the university will admit you. That means the university of your choice, they will admit you at 200 level. So you see two programs at the same time. And then we have skills acquisition program. This one is in two different locations. One is at that same Jabi, tailoring, cosmetology, and this catering. And then
we teach them those things there.
Exactly. Then we collaborate with the support of some NGOs. And this one is catch them at their slums.
Okay, we're going to enforce them, come out there.
Not, we are not enforcing, catch them at their slums, meaning we meet them at their own residence.
Okay.
After which they have done all their knives and what have you, by then their eyes is clear. But that
but how you go to, if I'm not fitting, know them, but as in, on a monitor them, go catch them, or on a already get their data, their details, on a go catch them. I don't understand. I don't do that one.
Thank you. You know, the location where you have this kind of people is not hidden.
It's not hidden.
It's
open.
Going by their attitude, dresses.
Yeah.
And you know, most of the time,
I think we catch wrong person, though.
No, we don't do that.
Only catch wrong person.
By the grace of God, no. You know, at night when they are out for that their business, most of them they do take different drugs, so they are not in their right sense. Mm-hmm. But after which, when they go back to their residences, their eyes clear. So we counsel them first, and then believe you me, many of them choose to repent. And whenever you're talking there, you see the emotion, you see the regret for them mitigating their body.
Well, my country people are there with acting director for social welfare, SANI, AMAR, of course, we'll talk about rehabilitation now. I will talk about the street, people in the street, and of course, the kind of work within the social welfare, with that department that don't do concerning rehabilitating human beings, because just as we talk to people, they get, what did they do? And also, they get a matter when concern them. Well, we could bring the video concerning the work when this FCT social welfare they do. When we come back, I still there with acting director SANI AMAR. Will they come back now?
I'm very happy and I'm excited about it. I'm happy to be one of the successful students of this program. Well, I want to thank the Honorable Minister FCT, Mala Muhammad Musa Bello. I want to also thank the Minister for State FCT, Dr. Ramatu Tijani Aliyu, and the Secretary SDS, Hajia Hadiza Muhammad Kabiru, for their support, for the extra miles they've gone to make sure that we become the best in the world, for giving us that confidence that yes, we must go to school, and for their support, their sacrifice and everything. And I must confess, they really tried. Yes, it's not easy. They did well, and God bless them. Well, definitely, I'm hoping that I'll become the best and I'll make this program proud. Wherever I go, I'll make sure I beat my chest and I said, yes, I'm proud to be a student of SCC, SDS.
Well, I feel very happy. I'm very excited for being one of the successful students of this program. And also, I want to thank the Honorable Minister of FCT, Malam Muhammad Bello Musa, and also the Minister of State of FCT, Dr. Ramatu Tijani Alihu, and the Secretary of the SDS, Hadia Hadiza Muhammad Kabir, for giving us this opportunity to be one of the students. And I also want to thank them for their sacrifices, for giving us the opportunity to be among this program. I'm really happy for being one of them. My hope for this exam, and I promise them that I will be one of the best students for this exam. I will give them my best. And I promise never to indulge myself in any malpractice. I promise to be one of the best students of this exam.
I feel so happy to be among you, one of the best students in this school, and the best successful candidate here. I want to thank the whole Minister FCT, Malam Muhammad Musa Bello, and the Minister of State FCT, Dr. Ramatu Tijani Aliyu, and the SDS Secretary, Hajia Hadiza Muhammad Kabir. I'm thanking them to make me happy among these successful students in this school. And I'm really appreciate them, and I promise them to be among the best students in this school.
Wow, so it's been a privilege for me, though. Seeing this program coming up all of a sudden is like a miracle for me, just to work on myself also on this exam, because I'm not paying any fee, it's free, and it's also helping most of us here who are not privileged of doing our exam in other places. Wow. To the Honorable Minister of FCT, Malam Muhammad Musa Bello, wow, he has been a good man to us. Whenever he comes here, he gives us advice, encouragement. Most of the times he comes, you know, his presence here is like a father to every one of us. And also the Minister of State, FCT, Dr. Ramatu Tijani Ali, wow, they have been awesome to every one of us. And to the Secretary of the SDS, we have Adia Adiza Mohamed Kabir. Wow, like 2 weeks ago, we finally met her in person, and it was like a great privilege seeing her in person. That seeing the person we've been hearing about her, seeing her in person, well, it has been a privilege. And we are really appreciating her, and we are giving her an assurance that this result is going to be awesome for her.
MashaAllah, I be very grateful and excited for this program. Well, since when we started from February to now, MashaAllah, I'm very grateful for that. First of all, I appreciate the Honorable Minister, Malam Muhammad Musa Bello, and Minister of FCTA, Dr. Ramatu Tijani Aliyu, and the CSDS, Hajia Hadiza Muhammad Kabir. Seriously, we are the hopeful. And by the way, I can say it, we are the best among the best. And we are the good citizens of this country. They will be proud of us, and we are proud of them too.
I think that this is the best of its kind. Creativity at its best. This is one of the students said in class one day that since she was born, this is the first time she will benefit such a thing from government. This is creativity out of the blue, people can't believe it. People didn't know that it is possible. But government of the FCT administration, Honorable Minister, Honorable Minister of State, Mandate Secretary, Director of Social Welfare, they've made it possible. And Nigerians are now benefiting from the real dividends of democracy in the education sector. Remember, COVID-19 affected education so much. So they are cushioning the effects of COVID-19 by bringing soccer educationally to the masses.
Well, my country people, of course, I don't watch that government help when it come from through this social welfare center, of course, when acting director. We do with me here, SANI, AMAR, the child, and some other big oga when I don't see for that, where they don't call their names, I don't see them. Well, acting director, sir. Now, Moku, look, the issue will concern see the street. You see, for example, like within Papa will directly ask you, this kind of matter now, for people when for those ladies who are outside there, when they do the same business, when the one decide to retire from the business, and of course, you want to give them opportunity to fit, take home, especially if maybe just the one you decide to us prepared on their own coming to meet this on a center, on a fit, accept them just like that?
Of course. You know, FCT Administration, Social Development Secretariat, is one of the components of the Federal Capital Territory Administration that deals with social services matters for the FCT residents. And all that is social services to help vulnerables and people who are critically ill and who are in their need for support, indigent family. If you look at this, our NECO, MAPTEP, IJMB stop, it's not only limited to our sister's daughter that are standing by the street. Even children of indigent family equally accepted. That make it to exceed our initial target of 500 to almost 3,000.
For every exam?
Yes, no, at once, not for every exam. You know, at once we targeted when we started, as we advertised, we were thinking we would not get that kind of response of more than 500, so we targeted 500. But the response was overwhelming, interesting.
Why go overwhelming for the kind of system we would do now? You're not supposed to overwhelm me. You know how things be. You understand? The point I try to make, people need assistance. Everybody needs help. In any form. This is not the best form of assistance.
Thank you. This one assistance. Is educational this one empowerment.
That's the foundation.
And then
foundation
they are just to get the basic requirement of education. Minimum basic. That is SSCE, NECO certificate. But you have already, you're a graduate, tell me what next are you looking for, and then at your level.
Okay, I won't be like you, because I know say you don't need to go pursue PhD, they pursue many things, you don't do, even doctorate, now you do, pursue, but at the same time.
You have that privilege.
Of course, we go help us, we'll go.
Let me not forget.
Yes, sir.
This services we are rendering is not limited to only indigent family or issue of having this educational qualification. We extend it to skills acquisition for self-reliance.
Now we
extend to these almajiris that are coming on the street with their, you know, plates, begging and what have you.
Okay, the almajiri matter now, they handle those ones also.
Yes.
To what extent they handle that one? Looking at the area council, looking at FCT, large place. How on a they meet up to this things, and how do they do on a operation?
Well, as per this almajiri school, there are not as many as in the northern states.
Okay, do you have
not
many?
No, many. There are quite a number of Islamic schools that are located around Dawaki, Kadupishmaki side, this Papi. That we have most of the Azuba. So what we did, we were able to identify their location, meet with their malams, and introduce this skills acquisition. If you go to our secretariat, from Monday to Friday, every day you see a set of almajiris learning either carpentry or shoemaking, the likes of it. Right there, if you go, we have the quite a fantastic, you know, product made by these people. And one good thing, what impressed me, their intelligence. They focus within the shortest possible time. Believe me, if you see the product made by this almajiris,
okay, thank you for now. But maybe I still ask, how you think, say, the students, where they come from that almajiri, you think, say, now all the students for the particular almajiri, because of the act, now all the students, they engage, or they bring come for now, or I don't understand, I saw some of the people, they willingly come on their own, or you understand what I try to talk?
You know, Social Development Secretariat has an enforcement team that sanitize the city street of beggars, mentally challenged, destitute, vagabonds and the likes. And then these almajiris are among those who are equally beggars, begging. You see most of them either around shopping centers, markets, road junctions, and the likes of it, or motor parks, and so on and so forth. So in the process of this, our enforcement activities, we come across most of them. As we met them being young, energetic, everybody and we discovered that apprehending them is not the solution. We reach out to their malams, we counsel them and we make them to understand, and they responded positively. And then they even promised the Minister of State, Dr. Ramutu Tejani Aliu, in one of our encounters with them, they promised that when they learn, they will go back and support government in training their own colleagues in their own school. And this will in turn lead the FCT administration to achieve one of the 13 mandates given to it by President Muhammadu Buhari in terms of getting, you know, job, self-employed, and removing at least 100 million Nigerians out of poverty in 10 years' time. And if you look at it, at least if you train 100, and this 100, each one train at least 5 or 10. So 10 times 100, you see you have 1,000. And these ones, and in turn train others. With time, you'll be surprised to see the number of people that will be self-employed among the Almajiris. And then we have introduced something for them to understand. It's not just going to school because they don't pay school fees, admission fee, or feeding to the malam. When their parents bring them, they'll just fold their hand and go back. The child is left to survive through that begging. So it was discouraging. It is an old and primitive practice which modern time people are beginning to understand its implications.
Well, my country people, I still are here with Acting Director of SANI Woman, of course, Acting Director of Social Welfare, and of course, we did look at the issue about social welfare, and of course, how it empower people, rehabilitate people to make them better persons. I will bring the scholarship video, I will bring the video to the registration. I will come back, I will still be here with Oga SANI, and of course, we will wrap up the program later. We will come back sharply.
Yes. That's 200 hold it, please. I'll start to do it.
Situation, right?
Yes.
So, what you need to do in life now is for you to focus on your education. When you focus on your education, you have built yourself. Because if you don't have that paper, nobody will take you. Nobody. You understand? So you have to work on your papers. No exam malpractice. Read. Let it come from your head. Let it come from your heart. There's no magic in it. We've all done it. We all went to universities. Even some of us are doing their master's, their doctorate degree. It's not a magic. It is a very simple thing to do. But you have to put your heart in it. You get it?
Yes.
So I implore you all to read your books. Come out with A's. So that we can see how you can further your education and become the best in your country. So I said, I want you to be what?
Good
citizen of where?
Our country.
Where is your country?
Nigeria.
That's okay. So let me have a
picture. Put it on picture.
So what time?
Well, under that one, of course, when the agency, the social welfare center, bring come, of course, I still there with acting director SANI AMAR, and of course, with a look at the issue about empowering, rehabilitating, and of course, doing many things for young persons, for people when they in need. We could look at the issue of people with disabilities. We know say that one another kind, another matter too. People with disabilities, people win one thing or the other, they affected with affect for their body with something, not their body one part no or something not okay. Of course, that for people they will never understand. Now, okay, how on are they meet to their those needs and of course challenges when those people they face and the challenges how until what they encounter in that one, because I know that one no go they still too easy to you get people when they see people when they hear people when leg the pain people. Just one form of this. Okay, how do you manage those kind of people?
Thank you. Well, the issue of managing person with disability, before I look at it, even myself, as something difficult. But with time, I noticed that it's one of the simplest things to be done. Most especially, as the FCT administration is supporting the secretariat and the department that is dealing with this issue, you know, squarely. We get all the necessary support, and all we need is just to understand the nature and how and what make a person with disability to react. Because of that, anything you do, unless if you are very careful and you understand their own psychology, that inferiority complex make them to react. They'll say it's because they are this. And the issue of disability is something that can affect anybody at any given time in life. So far you are alive until when you are dead, before you know that, yes, you don't encounter disability challenges. What we do in their own case when there is an advocacy, we reach out to them, we counsel them, and make them to understand. And we have quite a number of them that are very reasonable. Right from scratch in life, right from their childhood, they never embark on begging. And those people assist us immensely in convincing others to embrace, you know, self-reliant, you know, vocational skills instead of begging.
So it's like if you want to monkey, catch monkey from top tree.
Correct.
It would be very, very easy for you.
Indeed.
Okay, okay, that's a very, very good thing. With the wrap up.
But you know, Richard, what to surprise you to show you that yes, we are succeeding in that dealing of person with disability. Now, whenever our enforcement team goes out to arrest or apprehend beggars to remove them from the street, could you believe out of 20, you now hardly get up to 6 persons with disability? All the rest are everybody. I'm telling you, so everybody have now taken
care of the year. It's
a full business.
So the form say leg the pain or hand the pain, can't join. I don't understand. I want you to try to talk.
Believe me, there are some they fake their condition. Yes.
Okay, you don't
quite a number of times we meet people who fake blindness. When they meet with the nose, they were like,
"I'm gonna slap and I slap them for eye."
No. Since they are aware of this, when they meet with us, you see, they will trade the stick and run past their escort.
Okay, let me stop.
I'm telling you, some years back, they apprehended a young lady who is within 19 years. What she did was she decorated her own breast, foot, ginseng violet and some, you know, cream, some oil, injured oil and the likes, with plaster and you know, cotton wool, as if she has a cancer. Believe me, we'll get this lady.
Thank you very much. As you don't call sensitize the people, but of course, we thank you. Say you don't call tell us many things as it go. We will try and we will invite you again because. You know, if we talk everything finish, and so many things day ground when they happen. As me, I used to down here, so call for that your area. So many things don't they happen for as it concerns taking care of people and representing people. Well, one question I want to ask you: you say anybody when ready, willing to say one do that exam on training? If he come, on I go accept and true with that.
One hand,
make it come. Thank you very much. I wonder wherever you did the year before. This now FCT and an opportunity we get for it because of course with the good many states, we know many states that happen for many states. We don't know how many states get this kind of thing, but it happens for FCT here. Yeah. Anything way they do, especially those on the street, the ones where they are marginalized for streets too. They mean people with begging for street on Africa embrace this kind things when FCT bring come, and of course when director for social welfare can tell us for this afternoon. Okay, thank you very much. As you can tell us.